Hello, fellow readers and book lovers. Welcome back to our delightful journey through To Kill a Mockingbird, the literary masterpiece crafted by the brilliant Harper Lee. In Chapter 3, we delve deeper into Scout Finch's world as she navigates the complexities of childhood, social norms, and the mysteries of Boo Radley. Trust me, this chapter is a goldmine of insights, charm, and a dash of mischief that'll keep you hooked. Before we dive into the juicy details, make sure to hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up to stay tuned for more captivating book summaries. Now, let's jump into the delightful Chapter 3 of To Kill a Mockingbird. Chapter 3 kicks off with Scout's first day at school. But wait, the story doesn't just stop at the classroom. Scout's encounter with Walter Cunningham Jr., a boy from a less privileged background, takes center stage. Scout's teacher, Miss Caroline, misunderstands Walter's situation, and here's where the intrigue begins. Now, here's the hook. Walter's hesitance to accept Miss Caroline's quarter for lunch turns into an unexpected twist. Calpurnia, the Finch family's housekeeper, rescues the situation with a dose of wisdom and kindness. It's a moment that makes us question the assumptions we make about others. But that's not all. The Finch family's hospitality takes center stage when Walter joins them for lunch. Here's where the charm kicks in. The interactions around the dining table offer a glimpse into the Finch's values and the importance of treating others with respect. Now, here's the twist. Scout's innocent criticism of Walter's manners leads to an eye-opening moment. Calpurnia takes Scout aside and imparts an essential lesson in humility and understanding. It's a beautiful moment of growth and learning for Scout. Chapter 3 doesn't stop at manners and lessons. It's also where we get a deeper look into Calpurnia's role in the Finch household. Calpurnia is more than just a caretaker, she's a bridge between different worlds and an essential figure in Scout and Jem's upbringing. Now, here's the heart of the chapter. Calpurnia's role in raising Scout and Jem is essential in shaping their worldviews. Her guidance extends beyond practical skills. She imparts life lessons that will resonate with them for years to come. And of course, we can't forget about Boo Radley. The chapter takes a mysterious turn as Scout and Jem find gifts hidden in the knothole of a tree near the Radley house. These tokens become a mysterious link to Boo Radley, and the question of who's leading them keeps us engaged. Now, here's the enchanting part. The gifts in the knothole create a sense of wonder and curiosity in Scout and Jem. It's a reminder that even in the midst of daily life, there's always room for a touch of magic and mystery. And there you have it. Chapter 3 of To Kill a Mockingbird beautifully weaves together lessons of empathy, social dynamics, and the allure of the unknown. Don't forget to like this video, hit that subscribe button, and share it with fellow book enthusiasts. Join us in the next video as we continue to explore the layers of this literary gem. Until then, remember, kindness and understanding can often be found in the most unexpected places.